This video describes attack surface reduction in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint so you can better understand how it prevents attacks. Attack surface reduction is hardening the places where a threat is likely to attack, closing gaps to reduce the risks. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint has numerous features to do this without blocking users' productivity, and you can customize them to fit your organization. Use Microsoft Endpoint Manager or other management tools to turn them on and configure them. You can even audit these features first without enforcing them to understand how they might impact your environment. In this video, we'll look at some of these attack surface reduction capabilities, starting with hardware-based isolation. Hardware-based isolation protects systems from advanced attacks while helping to keep users productive. It isolates untrusted websites and PDF documents in a lightweight container, separate from the rest of the system. You define what is trusted, everything else is not. If the website or PDF turns out to be malicious, it's limited to the sandbox. Once a user closes the session, the threat is wiped away, along with any damage it might have done inside the container. The Microsoft Defender for Endpoint sensors are part of the container and will report a potential threat back to your console. So, even though the threat is gone, you still have visibility to it. While hardware-based isolation helps to reduce the attack surface area by isolating untrusted websites, application control in Defender for Endpoint can prevent untrusted applications from running. That's next. Trusting everything and blocking apps that prove malicious doesn't work. There's simply too many apps and too little time. A better model is trust nothing until it earns your trust. That's the idea behind application control. You identify which applications you trust, the circle of trust, and application control only allows those applications to run. Don't worry. Application control makes defining the circle of trust easy. First, you can trust all apps that have good reputations from Microsoft. Organizations can also automatically trust applications they deploy by using Microsoft Intune or System Center Configuration Manager. Using application control to block untrustworthy applications and allowing it to help you build a circle of trust offers an unprecedented way to reduce the attack surface area. Similarly, controlled folder access prevents untrusted apps from accessing protected folders. That's next. What if malware finds its way around all the other protections onto a machine? Ransomware, for example. Once it's on the machine, it can begin file encryption, holding your files hostage. This is where controlled folder access can help to protect your valuable data. It's very easy. You specify protected folders and only allow trusted apps to access them. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint adds apps to the trusted apps list based on their prevalence and reputation. If an app isn't trusted, controlled folder access blocks it from changing files in the protected folders. Next up, network protection offers a similar type of protection for network connections. Network protection blocks access to low reputation internet destinations by leveraging Microsoft's intelligence about the threat landscape. It extends Smart Screen to block all outbound traffic to dangerous internet resources by any application, not just Microsoft Edge. Additionally, network protection enables other capabilities, like custom IP and URL allow and block lists, endpoint policy enforcement for our integration with Microsoft Cloud App Security, and web protection. Web protection includes web threat protection to harden machines against threats like phishing sites, malware payloads, exploit sites, low reputation websites, and any site you add to the custom indicator list. All this works without a web proxy, by the way, protecting machines whether they're on the corporate network or not. And it reports back to the Microsoft Defender Security Center, so you can use those signals in your investigations. Like many other attack surface reduction features in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, network protection is super easy to deploy. Just turn it on. Next up, we'll talk about exploit protection. Exploit protection automatically applies exploit mitigation techniques to operating system processes and apps. Data execution prevention and arbitrary code guard are examples of these mitigation techniques. While you can enable exploit protection on an individual machine, you can enable exploit protection at scale by using Microsoft Endpoint Manager. Then, Exploit Protection reports events and blocks to Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, so you can use them as part of your usual alert investigations. On top of that, Defender for Endpoint offers attack surface reduction rules that give you more granular control over what behaviors applications are allowed. My favorite examples are macros. Macros are very useful for business, but they're commonly used by malware. With attack surface reduction rules, you can generally allow macros, but not allow them to create child processes or download code from the internet. The last capability we want to mention is device control, the ability to control removable media. Coming up next. With device control, security teams can allow or block certain removable devices to prevent threats they might contain. You can get rather granular with this configuration. For example, you can allow or deny write access to all removable disks or by USB vendor ID. And you can enable direct memory access protection to mitigate DMA attacks, including kernel DMA protection. By using attack surface reduction rules, you can block untrusted or unsigned processes that run from USB. These were just a few of the attack surface reduction capabilities that can help customers reduce the exposure of their machines. You can learn more about attack surface reduction in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint on Microsoft Docs.